What up, y'all? It's your boy, Dope Toys NY, back again. New video. This is going to be my updated collection video. I had done one of these about 2 years ago, and just recently, my boy Plastic Addict sent me the video, and things have changed. The collection's gotten a lot bigger, a lot more vast, a lot more variety in what I'm collecting, or what I'm collecting. And I just wanted to show it off real quick, give you an idea of what I'm working with. Just as a precursor, I'm dealing with, I got a Legends collection, Black Series, Mythic Legions, Mezcos, Neca, Figure Arts, Mafex. I got a little bit of everything going on. I got some designer toys, some independent stuff. Let me switch this camera around and I'll take you on a little tour. I'll start off with some Hasbro stuff, some average stuff, and then move into some premium stuff. So here we go, check it out. All right, y'all, I'm gonna start over here with some Legends. I did a Legends collection video back in 2017, and this is going to be more of my entire collection, but even the Legends themselves, I've gotten a lot more of those. I'll start over here because that's where I did in the last video. I'm not going to go figure by figure like I think I did last time, but I'll point out certain things. You got the Spider-Hulk in there. There's a bunch of Spider-Man was my favorite growing up, so there's a bunch of different Spider-Men in here. This one in the front, I think, is a Figure Arts Pizza Spider-Man. That's Tamashii Nation's The Samurai Spider-Man. So, you know, it's mostly Legends over here, but not all. Try to get in and see if you can, you know, Big Time, Future Foundation, bunch of stuff going on in there. And then I'll skip over this real quick, and I just, even piling over here, I got a couple more. That's, to me, this is the best Spider-Man figure ever made. That's that Mafex comic Spider-Man. That's a Legends, but he's got the cloth getup from GPS Lot and a pair of Jordans that a cousin of mine painted up for me. And that's the Mezco from the movie Spider-Man. But we'll get back over here. Over here, I start off with the Spider-Women. This whole section right here wasn't even... I had the shelf, but I didn't have the whole background. A couple of my favorite YouTubers made an appearance on my display. Your names over here, a couple of guys that I'm into. Pause. But yeah, this is a lot of this stuff is either Spider-Man based or just New York based heroes and villains. You got the Cloak and Dagger, that's newer. I got a Spider-Woman that fell. I wanted to try to go over it quickly before and make sure nothing was over, but Rogues Gallery stuff. I had a few of them last time. I even watched the video recently and I said I think I have most of them, but I definitely didn't because I have gotten a lot more. Oh, that's another Mezco homemade suit. Punisher's in there. Jessica Jones is newer. Silver Sable is newer. That's the newer Elektra. Fake custom Jigsaw. Punisher, I think I just said. And then this Spider-Man over here is dangling the Mary Jane. Top shelf, Black Cat, Moon Knight with a custom cape. That's the new Kingpin Builder figure, replaced the old one I had. J. Jonah Jameson is still in a pickle, tied up. And then up here I have a bunch of Venom and Carnage and symbiote related stuff. I don't know why this guy's bending over like that. I think he finally caved in. That was a custom that I had made. Monster Venom is probably my favorite. That thing is awesome. Toxin, you got a Doc Ock. I have the newer Doc Ock, and just I've left my toy biz up because it's easier for me. Moving over here, I got more Rogues. It's the newer Mysterio with a head that I custom painted. Hobgoblin and Green Goblin, Speed Demon, Boomerang, you know, more Spider-Man stuff. Moving over here, this hasn't changed too much. Just, I guess there's a lot more figures in here. But I got the Marvel Universe Galactus still, not the Build-A-Figure. King the Conqueror, Baron Zemo, I got that from my boy Grant. This one AIM guy is a custom that I did off of a Paladin. And I think I put more, I think that's a custom painted head too that I did. The new Claw, Sasquatch, Build-A-Figure, Singularity, I think is the chick's name. I don't think I had that before. She-Hulk I did not have. Here we go, Lady Deadpool. I changed my Deadpool section up a little. Got the Deadpool dog. Bob, the Hydra agent. Grimpool, his newer. I'm just trying to point out some stuff that I don't think I had last video. Not that it really matters. Over here, I finished the Wrecking Crew. This Crossbones has been knocked over. Let's see if I can get him to stand up okay. Yeah, not bad. Finished the Wrecking Crew, Madam Hydra, some more Hydra agents going on over here, the newer Taskmaster. Nuke is back there. I got the MCU Ultron in there as with a couple little extra bots. Hit Monkey's back there, Impossible Man. I think that's it for the Skrull, the Giant Man Skrull, that's newer. I got my Serpent Society going on here, what they've released so far. I think I got them all so far. This is like a Fantastic Four and Captain Marvel shelf. This thing is so crowded and it's like a narrow shelf, so it might be hard to see. But I've got the Walgreens stuff going on. What else is back there? I can't even see. Dread Knight. You got Dr. Doom in there. Can't wait for that new Dr. Doom to come out. A couple of Kree soldiers. Mole Man here in front. Down here, I moved into... This is a custom that Glenn Fitch made for me. It's a custom Mephisto with the Death from the Thanos Select. Dormammu. And some Ghost Rider stuff going on. I got two different versions of Ghost Rider. This is another custom from my boy. Who made this for me? Rico. Rico made me that. And these are also from Glenn Fitch. And then this was... I was actually talking about this in the last video. I wanted to get a Tri-Sentinel made. Pack Rat Studios ended up doing the job for me. And he did fantastic. Custom head. It's all articulated. All those arms are actually articulated. He made a custom back joint that... articulated. It's hard for me to get it out here, but that thing is fantastic. That's one of my favorite pieces in my collection. Hascon Deadpool that I got from Hascon is back there. Let's move in over here. A custom that I did actually, it lights up and stuff, but I don't feel like taking it down for you. Maybe I will. Hold on. All right, back. It's not showing too great on camera, but that's what the light up feature's on. I sculpted that out of a half dome piece of foam and some little parts that I had. Moving on into the Guardians of the Galaxy stuff. That's Ego from the MCU, just a human form. And some bigger villains that would be Guardians worthy. And I'm sorry for the shadows I'm casting, but you gotta do what you gotta do. I think I had a lot of... Oh no, I think I switched a lot of this stuff over to the best I could to comic book stuff as opposed to my MCU stuff, which I'll show later. That's probably the next thing I show. Moving on over here, I have a bunch of X-Force guys. Another custom by Glenn Fitch that Hasbro is now about to do for you guys. Warpath and Archangel are still pretty hard to get. The Psylocke, I suppose, also. And that's the old Hasbro X-Force Wolverine, not the new one. That's a standard Sentinel Build-A-Figure back there, along with the Apocalypse. Sauron, which is newer. I know that wasn't in the last video. Onslaught was... Let me reposition to over here. Another Glenn Fitch custom. That's actually the black and red suit that they made, just a repaint. I have the three pack. I didn't put it out yet. I'll probably keep the custom out just because it's custom. That's the old Mr. Sinister, Juggernaut, Dark Phoenix. That Magic is newer. The Cyclops I upgraded with a cloth suit from GPS Lot. The old Professor X, I have the new one also and haven't put that out yet. And the new Psylocke, newer Psylocke than what I previously had, I believe. Newer Archangel, or Archangel upgrade, I should say. Over here, we got a few multiple men, Kitty Pryde, and I think these guys were all here. Rogue is pretty sought after now, apparently. The X-23. I had the old Toy Biz Gambit up here before I started this, and he fell over. And I have the new one here, so I'll end up putting him out soon. And that's the newer Omega Red. Danger is hanging, along with Mojo. Over here are some Asgardians. This shelf only had a couple things on it last time. In front I have Silver Surfer from Walgreens. Apparently his pose is not holding. Beta Rebuild, I just got the newer one, and I haven't put it out yet. Boar is back there, that's newer. Magic, and Lady Loki. I got the comic Loki too and haven't put him out either. I think that wraps up my Marvel Legends, but I do have one more Marvel-related thing in this room.
All right, another quick update. In between the time that I filmed that first video and this, I added some things, and that Quicksilver is one. Boom Boom is in there. Cannonball, those weren't in there when I was filming. I switched up the display. I took that Blackbird out and included the new Professor X. And as far as anything else new, I don't know if this Mystique was out or the old one. She doesn't want to stand. Let me lean her. I think that might be it for the updates on this shelf. And then just some stuff over here. I replaced the old Beta Ray Bill with the new one and threw in the comic book Loki. Also added Guardian in there. He wasn't there when I was filming. I did the other day. I added some stuff that I hadn't had out. But yeah, I think that's about it. All right, and lastly, this is kind of like my pride and joy of my Marvel stuff. I have all my premium Iron Men, I suppose. Well, not all premium. Some are legends and, you know, stuff like that. But that's one of the old Revotechs. I don't even know some of these armors, but that's the Mezco Stealth. That's an MK1 from the MCU. That's a legend. This part is all figure arts. That's the War Machine Mark II, I think. And that's the one from Infinity War. Along with here, we have, so let's see. That would be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. They haven't done Mark I yet. Inside of the holes, I'm talking. And then that's the stealth version of the Mark IV, I want to say. That's the Hot Rod armor. That's the Figure Arts version. Sylvan Centurion's a comic cave. I tried to light up any ones that have light up features. These are a few legends with the Mezco. I didn't light up the Mezco in the middle, but that's the classic Iron Man from Mezco. The Tamashii Nations Samurai that I had the Spider-Man one like, and Tony Stark. Tony Stark is at his machine. I should have lit that up for you guys. That's one of the big dogs. That's the Hulkbuster 2, the Figure Arts version. And Igor's battery was dead, so his light doesn't come on. He's a comic cave also, and Rescue from Endgame. That's a Mark 50 with the Takara Tony parts, the aftermarket parts. Shades is lit up, and I forget the name of this one. That's also a comic cave. The lit up one's a comic cave. There's a Legends Mark 42 back there, I think that is. And then 47, and then 42, 43, and 44 here. And then that's the comic cave Hulkbuster. This might be my favorite piece in my whole entire collection. The thing is amazing. I don't even have words to say about it, but yeah, that's my Iron Man. I think the thing has a couple more lights that I didn't figure out how to put on right now. But yeah, that's my Iron Man collection. This is like kind of what I'm into. All right, I'll move on. I'm gonna move into MCU stuff next. All right, guys, moving on to the MCU. Sorry, I got a light out over here, so it won't be as bright as I'd like, but up in front I got the Netflix cast. And this was just, I know he's not MCU, but that's Logan with a Hugh Jackman head sculpt. Iron Spider. I just got Lewis from the Ant-Man pack. These two are Mezcos from Ragnarok. That was the two-pack Vision. Hulkbuster Build-A-Figure back there with Tony popping out. MCU Hulk and Bruce Banner. I don't feel like I need to name all these guys, but just to give you guys, that's a Figure Arts Doctor Strange. And a custom Figure Arts Stealth cap. And then your Guardians of the Galaxy back there. So that's the MCU shelf. Heroes. And then we'll skip down this middle one. Skip that for a second. And we'll move into MCU villains. Those are both of the Figure Arts Thanoses. Along with the Black Order. That Corvus Glaive is a custom. Another Glenn Fitch. Because of the lighting, his face isn't showing too well. But it's a really good paint job. These guys, these medals in the front I have as a distraction for my daughter because she can kind of reach this high, so she'll grab those before anything. Hopefully, that's the plan. Crossbones, Hydra, and Red Skull. Some Black Panther stuff, the Vulture, and Hela, Ronin, and that's another Ego. All right, while we're here, we'll move into this next. This is my horror shelf. It's a mix of...
Some McFarlane stuff, some Neca stuff, some Mezco stuff. It's a little mix of everything. Don't know if any of my followers are really into horror, but that's the Christine car. That lights up too. And these lights look like they're about to die because they're dimming too. A couple zombies. One on the left was a Christmas present. Pennywise. That was an SDCC exclusive last year. Death from Bill and Ted. Pale Man is newer. Mezco Alex and a Mezco Ash and the Mezco 2-pack zombies are all in there. Mezco Michael Myers. Mezco Michael Myers is the one back here, and that's a McFarlane, I believe. And then Jason, Mezco Jason. Waiting on that Mezco Freddy. And then that's the Neco House for a Thousand Corpses. Santee's back there somewhere. Godzilla's in there. So that's the horror shelf. This used to just be a G.I. Joe shelf. I'll start actually way up here. Not much to see because I can't get that high and it's not too lit up. But those are two G.I. Joe aircraft. The Night Raven and the Sky Striker. And then this started off as a G.I. Joe shelf. But now it's kind of anything that's 4 inches or under pretty much. These are Outer Spacemen. I know a lot of you guys aren't really into the art toys or the bootlegs or anything like that. Actually, those are Glios, so they're neither, but I know that's not popular. Beast Saga and Beast Wars are in here. Not the Transformers, but... Or Battle Beast, not Beast Wars, I'm sorry. Yeah, it's just a little bit of mix of stuff with the diorama piece I made. Any of the stuff that's displayed on a diorama piece is all made by me. Eventually, I'd like to get it all. All my shelves with stuff like that. And this is kind of a vintage... Most of this is vintage shelf. Visionaries, Silverhawks... Supernaturals, Exo Squad, Centurions, Dino Riders, Mask. I love the Mask. These aren't vintage, but they're just old school Nintendo stuff. The main guys are all Figma or Figuarts, so they're newer, but they're just older characters. Street Sorks, Bionic Six, more Mask. And then that Panther was from the newer ones, but that's a Thundercat, Rock Lords. So that's kind of my vintage shelf. And then moving down here, it was supposed to kind of be a turtle shells, but I guess I moved anything that's kind of samurai or ninja in here. Because I got some Bruce Lees. There's the NECA movie turtles. There's some articulated icons in here. Ninja Batman stuff. Diabolic. He isn't a ninja, but he kind of fit the motif. Goku and Shenron were my last two Dragon Ball figures. I got out of the Dragon Ball stuff. Ronin Wolverine, those are Figuarts cartoon turtles, and NECA Shredder and Krang. So that's that shelf. Give you a whole view of that one. And then now we'll get into some big boys, some premium stuff. Actually, I think we'll go, let's do Black Series next in Star Wars. Real quick before I start, I didn't point out the retro card stuff. This is actually the SDCC from this year, the one of the Hasbro exclusives. But I got a couple of those carded figures. Just I like the way the artwork looks. And then we'll get into Star Wars, which is also right here. A couple of Droid Factory figures that I built with my daughter. That was an exclusive for Halloween last year. Then along the top are the 40th Anniversary Black Series that were all on card. I kept those like that. Moving down, I enjoyed Celebration with my boys this year and got that Darth Maul graded. These few guys are Figuarts from the prequels. All this stuff is newer, and that's a model kit built by my boy Cesar Diaz. He did a wonderful job. I think it's excellent. Moving on, I guess this is kind of my newer trilogy stuff. Those are the Lucas Figuarts. The rest of this stuff is Black Series, I believe. Is that Rey Figuarts? I don't even know. I have too much stuff. In here, I got the Rebels team I just completed. I got the Ezra and I got the Chopper not long ago, but I got the Ezra this weekend that just passed. Those are your 40th guys loose with the 1978 original 12 backs that they were based off of, like their counterparts. I got the original versions and the 40th versions displayed. Two Jawas from each. We got a little X-Wing pilots going on here. Some Rogue One stuff up there, Baze and Chirrut, K2, some Death Troopers. This Han in front is Figuarts. Got a couple of Landos in there, as well as Han's daughter, Jaina. And then these Lukes, these couple of Lukes are Figuarts. This Yoda's from the Archive series, I just got that recently.
Moving down here, these guys are figure wards, the Amidala and Anakin, along with a couple of Black Series guards. My figure wards Obi-Wan collection, except for the Black Series one in the package in the back, which I try to freak and make it look like he's coming out of the package. Those are all the figure wards version to Obi. Grabbed this guy at Hascon as well a couple years back. Qui-Gon figure wards, Mace figure wards. Rex is back there. Wolf is there. Gree, Cody, and then just a bunch of clone troopers. Real quick, the speeder for Rey and Rio. I thought it was a cool character, but I don't have any of my solo stuff really out. Clone troopers, and then unmasked, disguised troopers, Luke, Han, and Finn. And then Tauntaun with Han riding it. A graded number one Star Wars from back in the day. Alright, and then stormtroopers. I got a mix of stormtroopers going on. A mud trooper, mountain trooper, Malik and Revan. The SDCC from this year, carded Boba, as well as an old Boba Black Series. And a prototype Boba and a Jango. Another SDCC exclusive from this year was the Sith Trooper. Back to some random troopers, some droids, Roger Roger. Praetorian Guards protecting, what's this guy's name? Well, I'm losing it. Well, Kylo and Emperor, whatever the fuck, just not coming to me at the moment. A couple of troopers on vehicles, Biker Scout and a Sand Trooper. Then here's my my Bounty Hunter setup. I got all the Bounty Hunter crew. A couple little Bulbas back there. Gree. And then the Carbonite Han and Jar Jar. IG-88 is from the archives. Whoops, pressed the button and stopped my video, but we'll go back to it. Bosh, Leia, Zuckus, Bosk. Some Gamorrean cards. And Jabba the Hutt. This was the other Celebration exclusive. I did not get that one graded. And then that Celebration exclusive from last year, your Han Solo. Luke Skywalker with speeder. Kind of hard to see in here, but the Emperor, Darth Vader. And you know, the Death Star Squad. Getting tripped up. Some Vader stuff here, random stuff. Which will bring me into my Vader collection, which you might have seen while I was doing Bounty Hunters. That's a Sideshow Vader, the Mafex hologram Vader, as well as the hologram Vader that I built that was a model kit. And these are just random Beast Kingdom figure arts, Mafex. It's a Revoltech, the one in the front of Revoltech. Tamashii Nations. Jesus. Just random Vaders. Vader's my dude. The Darth Vader number one graded back there. My little Vader collection. That wraps up Black Series. I'll give you an idea what it all looks like together, I suppose. That's what that's looking like. Another line that as of pretty recent has become like one of my favorites, Mythic Legions. I apologize ahead of time. I got my 3D printer running and I got it printing, so it's making noise. I'm sorry if it's hard to hear me over. But I'll start over here. I did it kind of like on the left side with all the hero type characters. These guys I definitely don't even know by name, so I'll just let you enjoy them just visually. I put all the hero type characters over here, some looking a little more shady than others, like that barbarian, I guess, is a hero. He is in my display. And there's also mixed in here, there's some NECA stuff, some DC collectibles, the World of Warcraft stuff. I'll try to point that stuff out. Obviously that pop up there was not a Mythic Legion. This was from World of Warcraft. It was a custom, they're called figure prints. Your character in-game, you can send away to have 3D printed, and my brother did that for me one year. He's from World of Warcraft as well back there. That's kind of the He-Man inspired one, as well as Battle Cat, as well as the Skeletor. And that's a classics, He-Man classic stuff. That's one of the rock trolls, one of my favorite guys here, Rhaegar. About to light a firework or a bomb for the Stone Troll. Classic Stan Dor based off Stan Lee. It's my little orc section. The red orcs are the Fury orcs, and the green ones are your standard. That's Thrall from World of Warcraft. Over here, this is the vampire section. I think Carpathius is the main guy. The Blood Knight, which I customized with the blood paint. Legion Builders and random, I forgot what the girl's name is, and then that's from Star Trek actually back there, looking like an elder vampire. A few Super 7 He-Men. This is probably my other favorite Legion, is Gorgo Aetherblade with the Aetherblade on a Spawn Horse. Got some goblins going on here. I love the goblin figures. I think they're totally underrated. A lot of people sleep on them. Thwip, I got him from ToyCon New Jersey this year. Moving on into skeletons. Pixis, Brother Mandibulus was one of the best ones in the series. He's badass, and that's the Lich King from World of Warcraft back there. And then some demons over here. I'm still looking for the yellow one like that, and that's his chick, I guess. And then a Scarabus, which I was lucky enough to get later. And these are two timekeepers, the little guys. And up here is just some random stuff. Stitches from Neca. Illidan is a World of Warcraft character. Some Dark Knights and the Ice Troll. Sylvanas is a Warcraft character, as well as the Bog Goblin. And moving on, since I'm already up here, this is like a little music section, music figures. I got the Iron Maiden Eddie, as well as Ozzy, some Misfit stuff. My Trap Toys stuff, my Iron Man. More Trap Toys, that Dal Slim is like one of 75, I believe. These are even more rare, the Toucan Sam Iron Man, or it's Iron Sam, which that would have been his card up there. And the Shaolin Chef, which is the Raekwon right in the front. A couple of Pops. These two custom black series were done by Hunter Knight Customs for me. They're made into the Hip Hop Troopers. And the two Biggie Smalls are older Mezco figures. This one was an SDCC exclusive, I believe. Pretty hard to come by. Got a couple of Pops here too. Stan Lee, a custom Babe Ruth, Mighty Joe, Jerry Rice, Michael Jordan. Just some favorites. All right, I'm moving out into the premium stuff now. And here's just some bootlegs, Warlords and Warwalks. They're like Ewoks, but the card art is sick. And then we got the Fuck Your Couch. The C-3PO Iron Man. Hype Beast Man with a Supreme shirt. And the Stay Fresh Marshmallow Man. Oh, lie to you. While I'm still in the office, I'll get to my Transformers stuff. This is kind of just all bunched up. Movie stuff. A bunch of Bumblebees. Cartoon stuff. Optimus Prime. Another one of the grails in my collection is that Lewin Optimus Prime. It's amazing. It's huge. It all lights up. Die cast. Like a phenomenal figure. Masterpiece Jazz. A couple more Autobots. And then on this side I have the Decepticons. The Alternator stuff I really like. Sorry about that. I keep pressing the button. The old Masterpiece Megatron. Trypticon. This is a third-party Devastator Jinbao Toys. Pretty gigantic. The old Masterpiece Skywarp. A few different Skywarps, actually. Iron Studios. Alternators. This is the new Ectotron, which is the Ghostbusters crossover. So this is the rest of the Decepticons, all kind of mixed up. All right, now we'll get out there to some premiums. All right, back in the living room. This is where my premium stuff is, but I'll start up here with some NECA stuff. The 18-inch Deadpool and Predator, the newer Voltron from the Netflix series, and then a few Predators that I just have lurking. Then back there is the Hasbro prop. And actually over there is the Cosmic Cube from Hasbro too. Then some alien stuff. I have the Red Queen alien. A few more outer spacemen, some alien props, thermal alien. Then moving over here, we'll get some premium stuff here. These are just random DC heroes that I had. The Super Friends are in the back. That's a Mezco in the front, the Arsenal, as well as the Catwoman is a Mezco. Red Hood is not I hope they make him. He's going to be a cool Mezco if and when they do. Mezco Dark Side, which is a pretty cool figure. I'm glad I got a good price on that. And these are the villains for DC. They're kind of bunched up, so it's a little hard to see. I'll point out the Mezco and the premium stuff. The figure arts is premium. I mean, the Deadshot is figure arts. Mutant Leader is a Mezco. Zoom is a Mezco. And Black Adam, a Mezco as well. As well as the Deathstroke is... The back one is a Mezco, and the front one is a Revoltech that I just recently got. I also just got that Bizarro over the weekend. King Shark Build-A-Figure. These are some random metals and X-ray figures. They were only small figures that I had to fit in this little area right here. So I mixed up DC and Marvel. Sue me. All right, now moving on. Let me take off the flash for this. All right, this is kind of where it's at for me. These are my premium. This is like my premium section. These are my details. I'll go into each shelf a little bit so you can see what's going on. These are Marvel Heroes. There's some Revoltech in here. The Spider-Man and the Gwenpool are Revoltech, as well as that Iron Man. Really cool figures. Spec Ops, Standard Pun, Doctor Strange. Logan is new. The old man Logan I've had for a little while, as well as Captain America. Then this was just kind of a tribute to Stan Lee. Guys as dark, dressed as darkly as they could, except for Captain America. But that's the Revoltech cap, and that pose was like what I pictured when I first saw the figure, so I was dying to get it in there. I made the little Stan Lee memorial piece, so it looks like they're all attending a funeral. Mezco, Iron Man back there, the LA Comic Con exclusive. Shadowlands, Daredevil, X-Force, Wolverine. These are all Mezco, or mostly Mezco. The Thor and the Hulk are not, obviously. Then moving here, I have some Marvel villains. Premium stuff. Well, not so much the Thanos, but I like that Thanos. Red Skull is a Mezco. Revoltech, Carnage, and Venom. Great figures. A couple little medals, and then a couple Deadpools. We'll move down here to some X-Men premium stuff. The Build-A-Figure Apocalypse is not, but I did touch up his paint a little to make him a little nicer. Revoltech Magneto. Love that figure. Gambit and Psylocke, as well as the Revo Wolverine. Love that figure as well. Here we kind of have like a Batman vs. Superman type shelf. You got the Batman vs. Superman Mezco, Dark Knight Mezco. That's the Sovereign Knight. Behind him is a Mafex armored Mezco Nightmare Batman. The black Batman back there is part of the set with the Superman who's on the other side. Batman Beyond, Superboy. Red Sun is a Mezco. There's the Superman back there that was part of the set. As well as the Cyborg Superman. And here is more of a Gotham-themed shelf. That's the Justice League tech suit. The Ascending Knight Blue. That's the new exclusive Jim Gordon. Back there is a PlayArts Kai Multiverse exclusive Joker. Clown Prince and a Figure Arts Joker. I got some Justice League stuff action going on in here. I just got that classic Superman Mezco. Really proud of that one. I love that one. As well as the Flash. That's a Revoltech Batman. A Mezco Green Arrow and a Mezco Shazam. Here's a McFarlane's shelf. Mostly Spawn. But the Pit Build-A-Figure's in there. Great figure. The Max is in there. Soul Taker, I think, is the anime one. And then just some random McFarlane stuff. That carded Spawn back there, that's actually mine from 1994, I believe. And then here we have some Street Fighter stuff. It's a mix of Storm and Figure Arts. The heroes are mostly Figure Arts, the ones towards the front and the larger Stormer in the back. That Vega's new, I just got that this week. Sagat was from San Diego Comic-Con this year. And I have Mike Tyson standing in as Balrog. And then you have the Storm Mortal Kombat stuff. Baraka being the newest, or my latest one. I didn't get that new Scorpion yet. But up to Baraka, I believe I have all of them. All the ninjas, Goro's back there. Shao Kahn is in there. Great stuff. These are great figures. Love them.
And then this is some less talked about stuff. These are 3A figures, highly detailed. That's Gola Valores is the space knight, or the space skeleton, rather. That's the blind cowboy with his horse. The horse is phenomenal. These figures are just, they blow you away when you have them in hand. Judge Dredd is back there, and these are the dark judges. Mortis, Fear, and Death. And then the to the right, we have Shadow Mirrored is the name of the guy. But perfect figures. They're weathered. They smell like oils when you open them. Really something cool. Just a mixed bag of premiums. To the left are some figure arts, anti-piracy figures, Bucky O'Hare, a few Thousand Toys robots. Agent Gomez is back there. The Iron Giant is by a Thousand Toys. Street Gomez, the new Storm collectibles, Marcus Phoenix, the GameStop exclusive, the exclusive Hellboy, and the exclusive Popeye.
Well, that's it, folks. There you have it. That's what I got for you. I got a couple other things hidden downstairs in the basement, a couple little gems here and there that I just don't have the room for right now. But maybe that'll be the next video. I do plan on getting my basement finished sometime within the next year. I really don't know when, but I guess when that's done, that'll be my next update. And I'll have some more goodies for you then. Until then, I hope you guys enjoyed. Like, comment, subscribe. Any questions, comments, I appreciate all your feedback. And I appreciate all the subscribers. Thank you.